Dear Father, I stand today just wanting to say thank you, Lord, for everything that you've done for me. Somebody's going to need you, Lord. Somebody's going to need a friend. Well, I stop by to let you know that I know somebody that'll stick closer than a mother, somebody that'll stick closer than even a father. Well, friend, I'm talking about Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lord.
Oh, yeah. Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Gail Davis, and you guys, you want to thank God today. First of all, we always want to thank God first and foremost. Then we want to thank Roscoe's Media Center, Roscoe Chicken and Waffle. We want to thank everybody to make it happen behind the scenes, in front of the scenes. We want to thank Kevin, my tech guy. You know, he's always back there making it happen. We want to thank Johnny Morris. We want to thank Kino. We want to thank the leaders of Roscoe. And we also want to thank my girl Melissa, because she actually did a show last year with me, and she has a show called Community with Me. And we have about 40 different shows here, right, Kevin? About 40 different shows here. So you guys look us up at rmconair.com and support, okay? Because we need you guys to support. Okay, so today, you guys, we're going to start off first half of the show with tributes to mothers. So since Mother's Day was yesterday, we're going to start off with some tributes to mother, and we're going to play some music. And this is dedicated to all the mothers that's here, all the mothers that have already gone to paradise and that's resting in peace. And we're going to attribute to the mothers that stepped in, you know, because we call it stepmother, but they actually stepped in and became mothers. We're going to dedicate this to godmothers. We're going to dedicate this to everybody who act as a role as a mother, okay? So this is some of our songs we're going to dedicate to mothers today. So our first song is Dear Mama by Tupac.
When I was pregnant in jail, I thought I was going to have a baby and the baby would never be with me, but I was acquitted a month and 3 days before Tupac was born. I was real happy because I had a son.
When I was young, me and my mama had beef, 17 years old, kicked out on the streets. Though back at the time, I never thought I'd see a face. Ain't a woman alive that could take my mama's place. Suspended from school, I'm scared to go home. I was a fool with the big boys breaking all the rules. Shed tears with my baby sister. Over the years, we was poor than other little kids. And even though we had different daddies, the same drama when things went wrong, we blamed mama. I reminisce on the stress I caused. It was hell, hugging on my mama from a jail cell. And who thinking elementary? Hey, I see the penitentiary one day. Running from the police, that's right. Mama catch me, put a whoop into my backside. And even as a crack fiend, mama, you always was a black queen, mama. I finally understand, for a woman it ain't easy trying to raise a man. You always was committed, a poor single mother on welfare. Tell me how you did it, there's no way I can pay you back. But the plan is to show you that I understand. You all appreciate it.
Lady, don't you know it, love is sweet.
Dear mama.
No one above
this. You all
appreciate
it. Don't you know we love you? Now ain't nobody tell us it was fair. No love for my daddy, cause the coward wasn't there. He passed away and I didn't cry, cause my anger wouldn't let me feel for a stranger. They say I'm wrong and I'm heartless, but all along I was looking for a father, he was gone. I hung around with the thugs, and even though they sold drugs, they showed a young brother love. I moved out and started really hanging. I needed money of my own, so I started slanging. I ain't guilty, cause even though I sell rocks, it feels good putting money in your mailbox. I love paying rent when the rent's due. I hope you got the diamond necklace that I sent to you. Cause when I was low, you was there for me. You never left me alone because you cared for me. And I can see you coming home after work late. You're in the kitchen trying to fix us a hot plate. You're just working with the scraps you was given. And mama made miracles every Thanksgiving. But now the road got rough, you're alone. You're trying to raise two bad kids on your own. And there's no way I can pay you back. But my plan is to show you that I understand. You all appreciate it.
Lady, don't you know we love you, sweet.
And dear mama,
place no one above you, sweet.
You all appreciate it.
Lady, don't you know we love you.
Pour out some liquor and I reminisce. Cause through the drama I can always depend on my mama. And when it seems that I'm hopeless, you say the words that can get me back in focus. When I was sick as a little kid, to keep me happy, there's no limit to the things you did. And all my childhood memories are full of all the sweet things you did for me.
And even though I act crazy, I gotta thank the Lord that you made me. There are no words that can express how I feel. You never kept a secret, always stayed real. And I appreciate how you raised me and all the extra love that you gave me. I wish I could take the pain away. If you can make it through the night, there's a brighter day. Everything will be alright if you hold on. It's a struggle every day, gotta roll on. And there's no way I can pay you back, but my plan is to show you that I understand. You all appreciate it.
Don't you know it loves me?
Dear mama,
place no one above us.
You all appreciate it.
Don't you know it loves me?
Dear mama, dear mama.
Hi, you guys. Okay, so that was dedicated to our moms out there. We appreciate our moms out there. And if we don't, we should, because you only get one mom. And so that was Tupac dedicating it to his mom, Afeni Shakur. And so we're going to just play some music today dedicated to our moms, because moms are so special. Dads are special too. But today we're talking about moms and we're appreciating our moms, okay? So our next song is Intruders, I Always Love My Mama. So this is a song, we used to sing this to my mom, you guys. We used to get up early in the morning and make her some breakfast in bed and then sing that song to her, I Always Love My Mom. So you guys enjoy this, okay?
Mama.
What?
She was the one we used to gang walk, baby.
Man, was we crazy?
Yeah, man. Give me that other fella, little Sonny.
You drinking that wine? Remember the schoolyard days?
Yeah. We had to take you home, man. You were proud of us,
oh,
man.
Oh, many a day. Lord have mercy.
Hey, but listen.
Yeah.
Remember when we used to run around there? Steal the hubcap off the car.
What you talking about? In batteries?
We lucky we didn't get busted, man.
Listen.
Then I say, here comes the fun.
Oh. Hey, Bird, what color was you coming to me?
That Tenderloin.
Oh, man.
Oh, man.
But dig this here.
Yeah.
Now, see, when all that gang war was going on, I'll tell you one thing I never forget.
And what's that?
See, when I got home, first thing I would hear is,
what?
Bill!
Yeah.
Where you been, boy?
That's it. That's it. Yeah. That's
my man. Say, I say, I was out with Sonny Bird and Lil Sonny.
Put it all on us.
Yeah. I had to put it on somebody.
Hey, Phil, what your mama say?
She said, boy, now I'm going to tell you.
What?
You know you getting big now.
Yeah.
You got to watch the things that you doing out in that street.
Right.
And you go to jail.
Right.
And I'm going to tell you something, man. Mama wasn't wrong.
No.
But what about Pop? Oh, we ain't talking about Pop.
No, man. Pop,
boy,
was, he was all right.
Pop,
was,
a lot of bad
Pop was hanging out, you know.
Yeah, hanging out.
I think Pop was drinking more wine than we used to.
I know my pop did.
Yeah.
My pop hung right on with you, boy.
Yeah.
Stay out all night. Come on, clothes all wrinkled up, lip balls all on them.
Hey, son. How about when your mom used to cook them good home-cooked bits of it?
Okay, you guys, we're celebrating mothers, okay? So I'm definitely a mother. I had a wonderful Mother's Day yesterday. My daughter and son-in-law and my baby daughter and my niece, they all took me to Claim Jumpers, and we had so much fun. I got flowers. I got a mother cake. I got a blouse. They really pampered me. My kids really pampered me. My son, he's out of town, and I know he wish he could have been there, but he put something on Facebook and almost had me crying, you know, had me shed some tears. So, you know, they celebrate me, right? And so, oh, yeah. And one thing I want to say, I said on one show that my son actually made the principal honor roll, but he actually made the president's and dean list at his school in Grambling. Grambling University in Louisiana. So I want to give a shout out to my son, and I'm going to see you real soon because he's coming for the summer. So this next song we have is from Boy Come In, and it's another song about mama. It's like, what's the name of our song, Kevin?
Song for Mama.
A Song for Mama. So all mothers should have a song, you know, a special song, because we are all special. We ain't talking about dads today. You guys get a turn next month. Your turn's coming up next month. Okay, so this is Boys to Men, A Song for Mama.
Down, you were always there to comfort me. No one else can be what you have been to me. You will always be, you will always be the girl in my life for all time. Mama, mama, you know I love you.
Always down for me, have always been around for me, even when I was bad. You showed me right from my wrongs. Yes, you did. And you took up for me when everyone was down on me. You always did understand. You gave me strength to go on.
There was so many times looking back when I was so afraid. And then you come to me and say to me, I can face anything. And no one else can do what you've done for me. You'll always be, you will always be the girl in my life. Ooh, oh.
Mama, mama, you know I love you.
You know I love you.
Okay, you guys, we're going to keep this going, and we just going to say a quick little prayer for everyone who's feeling very sensitive right now over their mom. We just pray that the Holy Spirit would come in and comfort you right now. And, you know, I know so many people that, you know, have lost their mom. My mom passed last year also in 2015. And so we just going to say a prayer that God will comfort you right now, and that you would know that she is with God right now, and you will see her again. So you guys act right so we can see our moms again, okay? And our next song is, again, Kevin, what's our next song? Earth, Wind, and Fire is called Mom. Okay, you guys, we're celebrating moms today.
Thank you.
You guys, I hope you guys are really enjoying our Mother's Day tribute, and we have some more music for you guys just to sit back and reflect on the good times, maybe some times that wasn't all that good, but at the same time, you only get one mom, okay? You only get one mother. So we're going to go to Celine Dion, and it's called A Mother's Prayer, and you know one thing about moms, we pray, because if I don't do nothing else, my kids have me praying every single day. And I know every other mother out there is praying for her child every single day. And hopefully dads too. But we're talking about mothers today. Okay, so we're going to Celine Dion, A Mother's Prayer. Go to Southern Gospel, A Mother's, what is it again? Can I say it one more time? Because you know, I'm learning some new mother songs today. So it's Southern Gospel.
Precious Mother.
Southern precious Gospel. Mother. I know everyone's mother is so precious, and we celebrate moms, you guys. So listen to this. You know, it's all about moms today.
Sweet and happy. bittersweet my weary heart would be if I could hear my mother pray. Shining gospel way. So trusting still his love, I seek that home above where I shall meet my mother some glad day. If I could hear my mother pray again, if I could hear her tender voice as then, so happy I would be. If I could hear my mother pray again.
Within the old home place, her patient smiling face was always spreading comfort, hope, and cheer. And when she used to sing to her eternal key, it was the songs the angels loved to hear.
If I could hear
if she could hear her mother's voice again. And, you know, a lot of us would love to hear our mother's voice again. Even if she was yelling and screaming, we would love to hear her voice again. Okay, so we have some R. Kelly, you guys, and he's dedicating this to his mom, Sweet Sadie. So we're going to go to that. Celebrating moms today.
Presents Bowling...
This song goes out to my mother, the one I love, and the one I lost. When it comes down to thinking about what my mother's done for me, the love she's given me makes it easy to do a song like this. So this one's for you, Mom. I love you.
Sunday morning, breakfast was on the table. There was no time to eat. She said to me, boy, hurry to Sunday school. Yeah.
Wow, you guys, that was a nice song. I really like that song. I believe that's a remake too. I believe that's a remake, but you guys just replaced your mother's name with Sadie. So he was dedicating that. And right now, you guys, we're gonna look at some pictures of me and my children, and you know how they took me out yesterday to claim jumpers, and my son, he's in Louisiana, but I want to show some pictures of him too. Okay, so that's some pictures of my son and me right there. Can you click on that, Kevin?
The other one?
Go down. Right there. Go up a little. Right up there. Right there, me and my son, right there.
Right there?
Yeah. So that's me and my son, you guys, and actually he came to the studio. He got one picture in there at the studio. Click on that picture at the studio. Can you click on that, Kevin? Oh, you can't. You can enlarge it? Okay. Well, you guys, he was at RMC. That's him and AJ. They came and did a show this year. Yeah, they came and did a show this year. So that's my son. And then, so we're going to go to some more pictures. We're going to go down to some more pictures. And go down a little bit.
That's whoever this is, man.
Okay. Yeah, that's me.
My show.
That's me and my son, you guys.
Go down?
Yeah, right there. Okay, now that was me yesterday for Mother's Day. Because, you know, I had my hat on. We went to Claim Jumpers, and we all in the restaurant taking pictures and having a good old time and stuff. That's me. Can some of the pictures come up? Or they can't? Well, that's me, my daughter. Okay, that's me, my daughter, and my son-in-law. And then the next picture is me and my daughter. Okay, so it won't let you go no more, huh?
It won't let me.
Okay. Well, anyway, my niece Candace was there, and we just had a great time. We was laughing so hard. We had a really, really good time, you guys. So, you guys, we're gonna go to one last song. We're gonna go to a commercial right now, and then we're gonna come right back, okay, with a guest, okay? We're gonna go to commercial. And so that's our celebration for Mother's Day, okay? You guys appreciate your moms.
In so many ways I can please. Hey, hey, hey.
What?
Okay, you guys, that was our dedication to our mothers, since yesterday was Mother's Day and we didn't have a show on Sunday, so Mondays. So thank you guys so much for tuning back in. And we have a guest on the show, you guys. He was doing auditions today, but he agreed to stop by just for a minute just to give us a little touch of what he's doing, because he's doing a lot of big things, you guys, a lot of big things. I am so honored to have him here. And we have comedian Casper Nelson. So, Casper, tell our people what you're doing out there. You're doing a lot.
You know, telling jokes until ain't nothing funny no more. Trying to rule the world and split it 50-50 with you. You know what I mean? That's what's really happening. Yeah. What's going on? How you been?
I'm good, Casper. I've been following you on Facebook, you know, everything that you've been doing. So tell our viewers about your part that you did in Hawaii Five-0.
Okay, Hawaii Five-0 actually was, of course, you already know, it's an iconic show. So,
exactly.
You know, it's one of the top rated shows on CBS, which CBS is one of the number one rated shows. CBS. And Hawaii Five-0 is actually one of their top shows. So it was a privilege to even be a part of it, you know what I mean? When I got the role, my agent actually told me, congratulating me because of how hard it is to get on that particular show.
Okay. You know,
especially for comedians, because it's not a comedy. It's a drama. It's a 1 hour drama.
Right, and you did a good job though.
Thank you.
You did a really good job. Everybody, and let everybody know how to follow you and connect with you, because they need to see that. You did a really, really good job.
Thank you. Well, you can always Google Casper Nelson. Anytime you're dealing with me and want to look me up, you want to spell Casper with a K.
So, with a K.
Yeah, so if you want to, and my company is 10 times funnier, so, and that's spelled everything out. So if you want to just Google Casper Nelson, spell Casper with a K, or 10 times funnier, TENTIMESFUNNIER, 10 times funnier. You can go to 10timesfunnier.com or just Google 10 times funnier. That's my company, which is a production. You know, we do comedy shows, which
awesome.
We actually have the legendary Tuesday nights at the Comedy Store.
All right.
On Sunset. You know, you familiar with the Fat Tuesdays at the Comedy Store? And we have the legendary, and we're the new hosts for that. So,
awesome. So
everybody that's in L.A., come out to the Comedy Store. May the 24th, we got Micah Blackston, which is the African King of Comedy.
Really?
And everybody loves Coco. We got Miss Coco Brown.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? And we got Darren Carter, the party starter.
Okay.
And we got my man, Gilbert Escobar. So, you know, it's going to be off the chain. It's going to be really cracking.
Oh, I got to be
there.
You
know what I mean? And that's May the 24th. So everybody that's listening, come out to the Comedy Store. Hit us up on the website, 10timesfunnier.com. Make your reservations. It's going down May the 24th. Michael Blackston, the African King of Comedy.
Oh,
and
my God. I got to see that.
I'm in love with my Coco, Miss Coco Brown, man. It's going down. So, you know what I mean? Y'all come
awesome.
And check that out. And be on the lookout for Criminal Minds. We just auditioned. We got that role. We landed. We booked Criminal Minds.
Okay.
So
awesome.
Y'all be looking out for that. And also, we got some more stuff that's kind of really, really heavy that I got to keep under the hat. I can't really, really give it out like that. You know what I'm saying? But it's really, 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 really huge. You know what I mean?
Really huge.
It's going down. You're doing big things, man.
I'm watching you. I'm watching you on Facebook. You know, I'm supporting everything that you do, because I watch you, and you wasn't a comedian at all in the movie. What is that? Hawaii 5-0.
Right.
So let our viewers know a little bit what you did, because you did a serious role, right?
Yeah, actually, it was a drama. Like I said, Hawaii 5-0 is a 1 hour drama series anyway, so it wasn't nothing comical about it.
Right.
The role, and actually, it was a groundbreaking episode for Hawaii 5-0. Hawaii 5-0 is actually a show that deals with four or five cops. And usually when you watch Hawaii 5-0, the episodes, there is about three or four stories going on with different about the cops.
Right.
Well, this particular episode, it was groundbreaking because the whole hour was based on one cop. It was one storyline about a 15-year-old case that came back and haunt one cop.
Okay.
So it was kind of a new structure for the show. They tried a new structure, which really, really went over here. We had like 14 million viewers for that
wow.
particular episode. So, you know, I'm just blessed to be a part of it, just blessed and humble and humbled to be with it, you know?
Yeah, you really keep doing it. So on the 24th of May, and what time is that starting at, Casper?
8 o'clock. Show starts at 8 o'clock on the dot. 8 o'clock on the dot.
Okay.
8 o'clock on the dot.
And say the place again, because I definitely want to be there.
It's the Comedy Store on Hollywood, on Sunset. The Comedy Store, the world famous Comedy Store, which is a comedy club. I mean, it's the world famous Comedy Store on Sunset, right across the street from the House of Blues.
Okay, so we got a few minutes left. So, Casper, I'm going to let you take us out. I thank my guest, Casper, for stopping in. I thank us. You know, we talked about mothers today. We celebrate mothers. But, Casper, let someone out there know, some of the things that, how did you get there? What inspired you to get there? Like, real quickly, what inspired you to become, you know, a comedian?
Well, actually, comedy is my first love. If you ask me, when I was 7, 8 years old, I wanted to be like Flip Wilson. Okay. I never knew that you could make a living off of it. I just wanted to be like Flip Wilson. You know what I mean?
Always funny.
Yeah. I don't know if I was always funny, but I always was interested in jokes. And if you told me a joke, I would remember it and I would tell them to my friends. So I remember when I was in elementary school, I think I was might have been the third, fourth, maybe fourth or fifth grade. Uh-huh. I would sit around at table and tell all these dirty jokes that my uncle would tell me. And at the time, I had all these kids listening. And what I was doing was actually comedy. I was actually doing stand-up comedy. I didn't know that's what I was doing. I didn't call it that. I was just telling my friends jokes that my uncle told me, but nevertheless, I had an audience, and they were around, sitting around, waiting for the next joke, and the next joke, and the next joke, and I was telling jokes, and this was in the third, fourth grade, so.
So, and it landed you here, and it landed you a couple of roles and everything, and some more roles, so you guys be looking out for comedian Casper Nelson. He's doing really, really big things, and I'm so honored that you stopped in to like check us out. I know that you're busy doing auditions and everything, but you guys follow him on Facebook and say your Facebook one more time and we're gonna sign off.
All right, we go to Facebook. You can go to Casper Nelson, spell Casper with a K. Now, actually, comedian Casper Nelson, I cannot get no more likes, requests. You can only follow, or you can go to my public figure page and like that. You can go to 10 Times Funnier, all medias. Twitter is TT Funnier. Instagram, 10 Times Funnier. Facebook, 10 Times Funnier. Casper Nelson. You can't get no more. You can only follow. But Casper Nelson, public figure, you can like.
Okay, so that's going to be it for our show today. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. I've Been Through It, hosted by Gail Davis. Thank my guest, comedian Casper Nelson. And to all the mothers, we love you. And this week, this show is dedicated to the children.
All right.
Okay, come back next week at 4:00.
Check that show out.
All right, you guys, check us out.
Next Comedy week. Store, May 24th.
Okay.
Michael Blackston, Coco Brown.
Dear Father, I stand today just wanting to say thank you, Lord, for everything that you've done for me. Somebody's gonna need you, Lord. Somebody's gonna need a friend. Will I stop by to let you know that I know somebody that'll stick closer than a mother? Somebody that'll stick closer than even a father? Well, friend, I'm talking about Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lord.
Oh, yeah. Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
'Cause I know Jesus will never I know.